All right, and here we are in the feature match area. John Phelps on Dredge versus Luis Scott-Vargas playing Blue White Miracles. Looks like John is on the play. Starts off with a Gemstone Mine and a turn one Putrid Imp. Discard of Golgari Thug at the end of the turn means a Dredge 4 in the draw step. And a Narcabibo straight into play. So pretty good start here for the Dredge deck, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, a turn one discard outlet into a Dredger, into a Narcomoeba. Get a little pressure going even. I mean, chip away at the life total, although that's not really how the deck tries to win. Looks like a Faithless Looting here.
Dredges the Thug. And into Stinkweed Imp option and another Narcomoeba. So, wow, quite a draw for the Dredge deck here. Now, I'm no Dredge expert, but this looks like the way that you want to start the game out.
I would think so. He has Ikarid. Also, to just pressure Luis. A Bridge from Below.
Option for Cabal Therapy, too.
Yep.
And Luis with just an Arid Mesa. Now, what is Luis looking for in order to interact with Dredge in Game 1? Does he have much? There's things like, Swords to Plowshares, Force of Will, these all do things.
Sure,
but not
they're
much.
Okay. Yeah, yeah, I mean, it almost feels to me like when you get fall this far behind on turn one, it's pretty hard to come back.
Yeah. I think generally speaking, when you're playing a deck like Miracles that doesn't have a lot of main deck action against a graveyard deck like Dredge, you're really just hoping your opponent has kind of an awkward start where they're maybe stumbling around for a couple turns trying to get things going. That is not the case this game.
No, and but after sideboard is where it shines, right? Like, you have cards that are so powerful they practically win the game. Like, rest in peace, Dredge just kind of can't beat
if
it's in play.
So Dredge is kind of doing its thing here. Looks like we have a flashback Cabal Therapy on Narcomoeba.
Did he not get a zombie from the bridge?
Looks like that. I think Luis just probably said, okay, resolves, name your card. And at that point, it was too late for Johnny at the zombie.
Okay, yeah, I mean, that is correct, but it doesn't look like he tried later. I mean, I don't know.
Yeah, always hard to tell exactly how those interactions go down when we can't hear the players or see the body language. But in any case, still a great start for John Phelps. Cabal Therapy there. Not sure what it named, but it at least got a peek at Luis's hand. Snapcaster Mage blocks Ikarid in combat.
And that'll exile the bridge.
Exile the bridge. Okay. So did John see the Snapcaster Mage in Luis's hand with the Cabal Therapy?
Yeah.
Okay. If so, I wonder... Yeah, I wonder a little bit about that.
It could be a misstep there. I mean, you're going to get a 2-2 anyway. There's no reason. I guess, yeah, I think it was probably just a mistake. I'm trying to find some sort of justification, but...
And here comes Breakthrough.
I guess it makes Luis tap his mana, and he gets to resolve Breakthrough.
Yeah, it's tough to say. It's always difficult to tell from our vantage point. We're not hearing what the Sayers are playing and following the exact details that closely. But in any case, it seems like all much is going according to plan for John Phelps here with Breakthrough, dredging a ton, discarding his hand. He's got a fully stocked graveyard here. Narcomoeba comes out. Trying to take a closer look and see if we've hit any additional bridges from below.
Yeah, there was at least one.
Okay. So counterspell coming down for here for Luis, but unfortunately a lot of the damage is already done on John Phelps' part. He does have access to Ikarids in his graveyard. He has one more bridge from below. He's going to bring back those Ikarids. That's going to enable him to do things like cast Cabal Therapy, make more zombies, and eventually cast a Dread Return. Dredge is the Grave Troll. Narka be the sacrifice to Cabal Therapy. Believe we should get at least one zombie here. Two more zombies, so it looks like we have two bridges in the graveyard. Counterbalance does trigger for a potential blind flip here on Luis's part.
Luis isn't going to try it because he's hoping he can counter something that matters. He doesn't want to reveal his top card, and he sort of wants him to like hope it's adjacent. He gets to counter the Dread Return because otherwise he can't win, and that's why he played the counterbalance.
Yep, Dread Return did reveal the top card there to counterbalance. That one was worth it, but did not hit, and Luis just goes ahead and packs it in. So, lightning fast game one there. Everything according to plan for the Dredge deck. That's basically how John Phelps wants the matchup to go, but things change quite a bit post-sideboard, don't they?
Right. I mean, Luis gets to bring in two Rest in Peace, a Containment Priest. Both those cards are just great.
Mm-hmm.
Almost all of Dredge's creatures enter the battlefield without being cast.
Right, like Ikarid that we saw there.
Anything targeted with Dread Return.
Yep. Okay, so we'll get a chance to see how that sideboarded match plays out. But in the meantime, we have a live look-in. We're going to take a look at our other feature match here.
Owen Turnwald against Lisa Seeley. Looks like Lisa won the first game.
Wow, so we're already on game two here, is that right?
I think I...
We'll get that updated for you all. But certainly interesting board here. It looks like Owen has landed a Blood Moon out of his Sneak and Show deck against what looks to be lands.
Yeah, lands doesn't function that well under Blood Moon.
I would imagine that is the case.
Of course, Owen has no blue mana right now. But what he does have is Sneak Attack.
But here comes Chalice of the Void on one.
Chalice of the Void for one is good against Sneak and Show, but Owen only has red mana anyway. Owen's just looking for any land to jam the Sneak Attack into play and then probably win the following turn.
So here comes Volcanic Island. Sneak Attack for Owen.
More mountains.
Yep. Look at all these mountains. And here comes Grizzlebrand.
Owen must not be at 20. He would have drawn before combat and tried to hit Emrakul.
Yes, that makes sense to me.
I don't know what he actually is at, but I'm going to venture a guess it's not 20.
Probably from tapping the Ancient Tomb a bunch of times.
Now he's at 8, so he didn't want to go to 1.
Okay.
Which makes sense. I mean, in fact, Lisa has in her hand, it looked like Volcanic Fallout to me, so.
I see. So good thing Owen didn't go down to 1 there.
Oh, he did go down to 1.
He
must have drawn again.
Went down to 1. Oh, okay.
He must have activated Grizzlebrand a second time.
I see.
Okay, so yeah, that confirmed that's what happened. He was at 8, attacked up to 15, drew 7, probably didn't hit anything that he could sneak attack in the following turn, so he drew 7 more and was like, whatever. If she has it, she has it, and she had it.
Interesting. I wouldn't normally expect Volcanic Fallout there.
No, I wouldn't either.
Yeah.
I wouldn't. I mean, Lightning Bolt, Punishing Fire, sure, something like that, just because there weren't enough cards to take out, but...
Interesting. That's a pretty cool game. I would have loved to see that from start to finish there.
Yeah, yeah.
Jumping in the middle is like kind of puzzling how everything is going on, but okay, pretty cool. So back to our main match here. This is John Phelps on Dredge versus Luis Scott-Vargas with blue, white, red miracles. We are in game 2. John Phelps up a game, blistering fast game one, where just everything went according to plan for the Dredge deck. But now we are post-sideboard against Dredge, so things become a lot more interesting and potentially a lot more interaction from Luis's part here. So turn one, Ponder starts things off for Luis. Looks like he goes ahead and shuffles.
Yeah.
So he's looking for something or is lacking something in his hand, right?
Might be that he has too many lands and saw too many lands, or needs lands and didn't see any.
Or he just has a fine hand, but he's digging for a sideboard card.
Rest in peace or bust, maybe.
Yep. Meanwhile, turn one, careful study for John Phelps off of Gemstone Mine. Always a nice start on turn one for the Dredge deck. Looks like he has Stinkweed Imp, and Narc Amoeba to discard there, and a Faithless Looting to follow up, so we could see a pretty explosive turn two here if Luis doesn't have something to say about it.
Well, no rest in peace, or no white mana.
Okay, Scalding Tarn for Luis. Probably setting up to shuffle away those cards for the Brainstorm, and getting another look for sideboard cards.
Wes Alves, please report to the red side of the stage.
So it looks like, is that a Faithless Looting, the red card in John's hand?
Yeah, I believe he does have a Faithless Looting, so a lot of dredging can happen this turn. Ghost of the Putrid Imp, okay.
Interesting that he chose to play Putrid Imp.
Yeah. I would have expected the Faithless Looting, but then again, I'm definitely not that experienced with
either,
Dredge,
but
so happy
it just doesn't seem
here.
Like you already have a Dredger in your graveyard. Doesn't seem like Putrid Imp just contributes much to your game plan here.
Mm-hmm.
To me, I mean.
It's possible it's in some way kind of a hedge in case Luis is able to empty his graveyard with like a Relic of Progenitus or something, then he still has a discard outlet.
I guess Relic, sure, but rest in peace.
I mean, rest in peace is
Or cage.
That's
or
the hammer no matter what, but.
All right, so this is cool. Luis's plan is just to race.
The beatdown.
Yeah.
Ikarid comes in. Dredging Golgari Grave Troll for 6. Flips another Ikarid there. Doesn't look like any bridges from below.
There's one bridge on the right of the Faithless Looting.
Oh, I see. Yeah, from the first set of cards there. Okay.
There's two more bridges. What is that green card?
Nature's Claim, possibly?
Okay, yeah, that's what it is. So three bridges in the graveyard.
Okay, so no attack from the Ikarid. Not wanting that same situation that happened in game one where a creature blocked.
I thought there were three bridges.
Maybe
I'm mistaken.
I see two. It's always a little hard to tell because I think there's new art on the Modern Masters ones. So,
okay.
Yeah, but I think I see two future side bridges in there. So down comes Jace the Mind Sculptor. So Luis is doing powerful things, but they're like normal powerful things, you know? Not things that really interact particularly well against Dredge's game plan. I mean, Jace can dig for more sideboard cards, maybe bounce some zombie tokens, although that's probably a losing battle at this point.
Yeah, Luis is... I don't know. I think Luis is actually debating on between bouncing a zombie token and brainstorming with his Jace.
Mm-hmm. I mean, with the Ikarids in the graveyard and the two bridges, I think the zombie army will just replenish itself faster than Luis can really do much about it. So it makes sense to just look for rest in peace, basically, here.
Yeah.
So moving to John Phelps' upkeep, here come two Ikarids, Golgari Grave Troll getting dredged, flipping a Narc Amoeba.
Another bridge.
Third bridge, and also a Cabal Therapy. So I think at least two Cabal Therapies in the graveyard as well. So
is the game? Is it over?
It potentially could be.
Is there a Dredge return in the graveyard?
I don't see one. Black cards,
what
I see.
What got Cabal therapied away? A Narcomoeba?
The Narcomoeba that came in, yeah. So there should be zombies coming
in. So the bridge triggers got missed, I guess. Or maybe. I don't know.
Oh, I see. I think there is a Dredge return there. In the second row, there's kind of glare on it right
okay.
now. But yeah, it's right next to the mana confluence. So there is a Dredge return, three bridges.
But he doesn't have the Zealot, right? The Flame King Zealot? Like, he can Iona...
No, he hasn't milled it yet.
He could Iona... I mean, Iona isn't very good against Jace, though. He can't really attack the Jace, because then he loses his bridges.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it looks like he may have to be patient here for one more turn, at least. So actually opting to attack here with the Icarits.
Are we assuming they're attacking Jace?
Yes.
Yeah.
And there go the bridges.
Yeah, and now Luis... Now John has nothing. No creatures and no bridges.
Yeah, that's interesting. I was expecting to see John just pass the turn, make six more zombies... Luis has one turn with...
Because one of the... Yeah, okay. Because one of the 2-2s got blocked by a
one
monk.
So
yeah.
One zombie stays in play. So that's right. Not a new zombie. That's the one that should have stayed in play from
right.
from combat. Okay, and post-combat, here comes Iona. So now that Jace is gone, Iona being pretty powerful.
Yeah, this is tough.
Yep, definitely tough for Luis. I mean, on the one hand, whether... He named white or blue with Iona. Luis still has outs to the Iona.
Right.
But he doesn't have a lot of time now with the Icarus
right.
coming in. So.
You would think he named white.
Yeah, usually that's the name here. Because stop source to plowshares, terminus, things like that.
And I guess he hit the last bridge that turn.
And that is it. Luis Scott-Vargas is defeated here in round 9 of GPC TAC. It's tough stuff. Dredge is a really challenging deck to go up against. It's very hard to interact with, and when it gets good draws and you can't find your sideboard cards, often it feels like there's not that much you can do.
It does.